Testo. It's on us, TV 58.
Cornette, you manage a pair and you're shaped like a pair, but apparently you don't realize whether it's singles or tags. This lean, mean flying machine is at full throttle. Tell them to you, man.
That's right. One-on-one, Flying Brian against Bobby Eaton today on the show. Jim Cornette, I'm going to be at ringside, so are you. You stick your nose in our business and I'm going to knock your block off, doughboy.
Edition of Worldwide Wrestling is being brought to you by Castrol Motor Oil, engineered for today's smaller cars.
Howdy, you simple-minded people! Welcome once again to Worldwide Wrestling. I'm Tuxedo Terry, along with Crispy Cruz, and he's the kind of fella that loves to keep his mouth open all the time. And Crispy, have we got a show for him today or not?
That's right, fans. In Funk's Grill, Norman and the Box. Also, Doom will be here. We are going to see in action the future heavyweight champion of the world, Lex Luger.
Tell him what else we're going to see.
And in our main event, Lion Brian is going to take on beautiful Bobby Eaton. But now, Sting, welcome to Worldwide Wrestling. It is so good to see you. Certainly inspirational to so many kids around the world. And you know, tens of thousands, and I do mean tens of thousands of cards have been pouring in. It is so good to
see you. Hey, Crispy, wait a minute. I've got some questions that I would like to direct to him.
Okay. I'm listening. Ask away.
Okay. I want to ask you if you've ever heard of Seattle Slough. You know, she was a famous racehorse. Unfortunately, that racehorse broke its leg and it never ran again. I'm asking you about Joe Theismann. Did you see the hit that he took whenever he was playing for the Washington Redskins and he never played another down? I'm asking you about Billy Sims, the Heisman Award winner, that 4 years into his career, he took a shot and he never came back. What I'm asking you to do, Sting, is to face reality. And the reality is, there's a great possibility that you can't come back like these others never did. Face reality.
Well, let me tell you something, Terry Funk. Joe Theismann, Seattle Sue, whatever those people were, yeah, they had bad knee injuries, they never came back, and my doctor told me, he said, Sting, you might not come back, and if you do, you might not be 100%, but you see, the difference between me and those other guys is they're normal athletes. I'm abnormal, okay? I'm not normal at all! So don't ever, ever second guess me, because I'm Sting, I'm a little bit different, I'm abnormal, I'm weird, and my knee's gonna come back 100%, I guarantee.
We'll be back right after this important message.
Whoa, totally way chill, California.
Yo,
cool muscle dude, Stingman.
Like what, Sting? Like where on his
like
feet?
Ruse, dude.
Ruse.
Shoes for your feet, pockets for your stuff.
Wouldn't it be great if you could turn an old den like this into a dream den like this without paying for it? And wouldn't it be great if all it took was finding beer in a store? Announcing Keystone's Dream Den Giveaway. Just go to a store, find Keystone and Keystone Light, and enter. If you win, say hello to this big screen TV, deluxe stereo, mini refrigerator. How about a pool table? Keystone's Dream Den Giveaway. Wouldn't it be great if you won?
Touchstone Pictures presents Ernest P. Worrell. He's getting a taste of the law and giving justice a new face in an all-new adventure.
Excuse me, sir, are you all right?
Just fine, thank you.
Ernest Goes to Jail, rated PG, starts Friday, April 6th at a theater near you.
You're about to see an amazing transformation as this bald man becomes unbald. Did his hair grow back? No, but the next best thing, new gradual hair replacement from Natural Look Hair Centers of Sacramento, Modesto, and Walnut Creek. This new process replaces hair slowly, over time, so no one will ever know. Hair that looks like it's growing back. From Natural Look Hair Center, call for a free brochure today. Natural Look Hair Centers of Sacramento, Modesto, and Walnut Creek.
In creating the perfect mix of music for the new Mix 96, we discovered there are three kinds of songs. The good.
The lift is up where we belong.
The bad. And the ugly. We decided to stick with the good ones. Mix 96, always the perfect mix of music.
In the ring from New York City, this is Robbie Idol. And his partner is from Northport, Florida. This is Bob Cook. Their opponents are led to the ring by Mr. Sugar Ray Long. Introducing the team of Butch Reed and Ron Simmons, this is the team of Doom.
He has the gall, the nerve to say, that he was the former sparring partner of Sugar Ray Leonard, but the Sugar Ray Leonard was
all over him, it's all over, baby.
That's ridiculous.
Oh yeah, does he have a mouth on him? I'll tell you what, that Teddy Long, Sugar Ray Long, I said before, he could eat a banana sideways, couldn't he?
What a man, huh?
Well, I can't disagree with what Ron Simmons just said. You're right, what a man. Terry, I never thought there'd be a team that could defeat the Road Warriors. Please don't do that.
Look at that footwork. It makes me want to get up and dance with that boy. Look at that rhythm he's got. Off of one rope, back off the other. That's my man, Teddy Long.
He's got so much, maybe he could lend you some. You sure need it.
Oh, I like the way he talks, too. He talks so much, you know, but I like what he says. You know, you talk a lot, and sometimes I don't like too much what you say, Crispy, but I like what Teddy Long says.
We'll have a word from Paul Ellering as to just what he feels about Teddy Long coming up right after this match in Funk's Grill. Also in Funk's Grill, Norman's Box. What is that all about?
Well, I don't know, but boy, you saw some power pushing Bob Cook right down there. I don't know what's in that box.
Bob Cook's a big guy, 6'2", 6'3". Oh, he catches Simmons with a drop kick, surprises him. Some lights that don't seem to be doing too much to Ron Simmons. Simmons with a headbutt. A double axe handle blow to the back of the neck of big Bob Cook.
Look at the power that Simmons has. You know, that Teddy Long, he's sassy. And his team is sassy. Have they come a long ways or not?
No doubt about that. Fans, Lex Luger will be here. Also, the Minnesota Wrecking Crew, too, with Ole Anderson.
Whoa!
Pancake Bob Cook. And our main event, it's a captain's match. Flying Brian against beautiful Bobby Eaton.
Look out for that clothesline. He caught him a good one right then, Crispy.
Terry, I wanted to mention to the fans that I'll be talking live with Ric Flair in the ring. Not a place that I really want to be with Ric Flair, but that's what the producers have said for me to do, so I'm going to be inside the ring. Oh, neck break.
Snapping back into the mat with that base of that head hitting first. There's a two count. This might be it. He pulled him up. That would have been it.
That's Teddy, I beg your pardon, that's Sugar Ray Long saying, not now, not now. He looks ridiculous with those boxing gloves.
Hey, I'll give you the opportunity.
Yeah, right.
Fight, baby.
Hey, would you like to get in there and go a couple of rounds with Teddy Long? You're both about 140 pounds. We might get a chance of seeing him and Ellering go at it.
Now, this is what I call fun.
I'm a man of words, not of fists. And lucky for me that I am. Butch Reed connects.
I'll tell you what, that'll take the determination out of you whenever you hit the guy
and
with your best right.
That's what's going to happen to Paul Ellering. When he steps into the ring with me, I'm going to knock his face off, Betty. You better believe it.
Well, please, let's get back to the action now. Simmons and Reed whip Bob Cook. Have we seen Robbie Idol yet? I don't think so.
Haven't seen him in a ring at this particular time.
And then there are leg drops. Ron Simmons is the textbook. And it is a high leg drop.
I'll tell you what, Simmons just keeps on pulling him up. Even the fans are wanting to end this thing at this particular time.
Power slam on Cook. This could be it. Oh, come on.
Come on. Go ahead and beat this man.
Even Simmons is getting upset with Sugar Ray Long. Hear somebody scratch their fingernails on a chalkboard than listen to Long. One, two. Oh, come on.
You know, he is kind of irritating at times.
I thank you.
At times.
Thank you. Now, I thank you for agreeing with me on that. Now, the first appearance of Robbie Idol.
Let's see how Idol does here. Oh.
Idol played minor league baseball in the Bluebirds organization, Blue Jays organization, I should say.
It looks like he was quite a catcher, doesn't it? He's catching a lot of blows right now, Crispy.
That's right, Buck, keep on that head.
Oh, come. I'm sorry, I'm saying that too much, but gee.
Oh! Driving pile driver. Look out, Crispy, look out. I smell something here. Look out for that flying clothesline.
Authority. Here comes the three count. No doubt, that's it.
The winners of the match, the team of two.
Fans, an important message now, then a break, and we'll be right back with Funk's Grill. Don't go away.
No, it never fails to amaze me how the Freebirds can come out here and tell the whole world they're the greatest rock and roll band of all times. But you see, Michael Hayes and Jimmy Garvin, when it comes to music, it's not, brother, being the best. It's how you feel. You put your soul into it, brother, to let the people know how you feel when it comes to music. See, you know nothing about that. So but you tell the whole world how great you are. But when it comes down to us, we're going to show you, Freebirds, that when it comes to wrestling, that we are the greatest rock and roll team around here in the NWA.
They're young.
Yay!
They're cool.
Excellent!
They're amphibious.
You never asked to look for a can opener.
America's most radical superheroes are now a real live movie.
A fellow chucker, eh?
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Cowabunga!
Rated PG. Lean, green, and on the screen, March 30th at theaters everywhere.
Triumph is ours!
The battle of wizards and warriors continues with Iron Sword.
Malkil will take on the shape of the earth, wind, water, and fire.
The fate of the world is in your hands!
Get Iron Sword for your Nintendo Entertainment System from Acclaim.
Double Dragon 2, The Revenge, for your Nintendo Entertainment System. The best action game ever from Acclaim.
It's the adventure of a lifetime. And the race of a lifetime.
That horse has got speed. He ain't even tapped you.
We're gonna show everybody that he's the fastest horse in the world.
Hoyt Axton, Terry Garr, and Mickey Rooney in a movie you'll never forget. The Black Stallion. Sunday at 6 on the TV 58 Cinema Showcase.
If you're thinking about changing the tires on your car, here's something to consider. Every Bridgestone tire you buy comes with something built in. Confidence. So you can have Bridgestone confidence no matter what you drive.
Northern Tire and Wheel, your Bridgestone headquarters with four convenient locations to serve you. The confidence of Bridgestone and the quality and service of Northern Tire.
It's Fred and the guys. Hey, you know, they interviewed four people today for your job? Just kidding.
The effects of an accident can leave you on the outside, looking in. Accidents don't always happen to someone else. One day, you may be faced with circumstances way beyond your control. When that day comes, Accident Counseling Incorporated can help you regain control of your life. Call 1-800-648-1331.
Howdy, you simple-minded partners. Welcome once again to Funk's Grill. And I've got this box here. And I've got Norman the Nitwit, if he doesn't mind coming in, with this box. And it's a surprise box.
Yeah, this is a surprise for Kevin Sullivan.
It's a surprise, all right, but it looks just like a black box to me.
No, there's a big boogeyman in here.
Boogeyman?
Yeah.
It's just a black box.
No, I told you there's a big boogeyman in here.
No, it's a black box. It's no boogeyman.
Look right here. I painted that myself. Boogeyman, right there, painted it right on the front.
Why, you imbecile, black on black will never show up. That's all you are is an imbecile.
Terry Funk, you know something? I'm getting tired of you calling me all those names like imbecile all the time.
Well, what if I call you something 144 times better than an imbecile?
Okay.
All right, I'll do that. You're a gross imbecile.
Ha! That's a lot better. That's nice.
All right, now go on. Get on out of here because I've got something else, somebody else here to talk to. Boogeyman. Sounds like a Honda commercial to me.
Harley Davidson.
Harley Davidson? I'll bet you're right, because you're the kind of man that knows. You know, I want to talk to you about Sugar Ray Long. I bet you thought I was going to say Leonard, but I'm talking about Sugar Ray Long, the man that has the fastest hands in the world, the man that can dance so well, the man that even says that Sugar Ray Leonard was his sparring partner.
Terry Funk, let me tell you something about Teddy Long. Teddy Long, you are an unctuous miscreant. Teddy Long, you are a man who is swimming in deep water, and you're swimming away from shore. Teddy Long, you will live to regret the day your little peanut head and your little beady eyes set on Paul Ellering. Because, Teddy Long, I didn't get to where I am today without stepping on a few toes, Teddy Long. I'm a bad apple, Teddy Long, and now I'm going to step all over you. Your screams, Teddy Long, are going to be like the screams of a hog in the slaughterhouse. They will be meaningless. Teddy Long, you are mine. You are going down big time.
Now, fans, it's time for this week's Castrol High Performance with the Steiners. This week's Castrol High Performance of the Week features the World Tag Team Champions, the Steiner Brothers. First, it's the upside-down slam by Rick Steiner. And then we'll take a look at the Tilt-A-Whirl Slam by Scott Steiner, followed by the Steiner Line by the Dog-Faced Gremlin, and then the most incredible move in all of wrestling. It's Scott Steiner's Frankensteiner, the Steiner Brothers. This week's Castrol's High Performance Action of the Week, the Steiners and Castrol.
In today's higher revving and hotter running engines, wear is a greater problem than ever before. Oil breakdown can shorten the life of vital engine parts. That's why there's Castrol. Castrol provides maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown. So use Castrol, because driving today can be a grind. Castrol, engineered for today's smaller cars.
Since the beginning of time, Satan has worked to create the perfect killer. One who kills many without reason. One who cannot be stopped. Today, that man exists. Be warned. The First Power. Lou Diamond Phillips. Rated R. Starts Friday, April 6th.
The 70s were the decade of self-interest. The 80s, the years of world interest. This, however, is the year of no interest. Pay no interest for 1 year, plus put no money down during the 1 year free financing sale at The Bedroom. You'll also save on a huge selection of beds and bedroom furniture, from black lacquer to solid oak to Sealy Posturepedic. Global interests are great, but no interest is better. Pay no interest for 1 year and no money down now at The Bedroom. Offer good with $1,000 minimum amount purchased and when balance is paid within 12 months.
If you're like Mimi, you take control of your life. Dating is fun, but a commitment is more important. I thought all the good ones were gone, until I called Connections. It was easy. I listened to a lot of messages, and then I left a message for a guy who said the things I wanted to hear.
Connections USA. Connect with someone near you.
Talk about a commitment. Meet Don, my fiancé.
$1.45 per minute.
Wrestling fans, the following contest is set for one fall. In the ring from Knoxville, Tennessee, this is Joe Kazana. His opponent is the current United States Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. From the Windy City in Chicago, Illinois, the total package.
Professional wrestling today. His words and words with which I agree. He's wearing a very prestigious belt, second only to the World's Heavyweight Championship. And I think that is forthcoming as well, Terry. And it would be the first time since 1905 in the NWA that a U.S. Heavyweight Champion has also held the world title. The first time in nearly a century.
I know that. You talked to Lex Luger earlier, and I know what he said. He said that he had Ric Flair's number, didn't he?
He did. And I'm going to tell Ric Flair just what Lex Luger told me when I speak to him live just a little bit later in the program.
Hey, have you got my number? It's 1-900-909-9900. Ha ha, you can call me. Yeah, I'll tell you a lot of silly, silly things.
Weird happenings in the NWA. Is it Monday nights with Terry Funk?
Yes.
Make sure your parents give you permission before you call. $2 for the first minute, 45 cents each additional minute. Luger kicks out there from Kazana. He backs up a bit. Joe Kazana, this is the big break of his career. Now they tie up.
You know, you can take the height, the reach, the size, the strength, the ring savvy of Luger. You can take all of these particular things that he does have and he does possess. He does possess so many things. But you put him in there against Flair. And you must remember that Flair is a legend. It's very difficult to beat a legend. You're at a disadvantage when you go in the ring with a legend because you're constantly thinking, this man has approached and done things that I possibly never will.
And Kazana has done things that he wishes he never did. He's whipped into the ropes by Luger. Oh, slam. This should be it. But Luger signifies the torture rack is coming up. This is how he will beat Ric Flair. I am convinced of it. This should be it.
Now you see Luger going down to Kazana, picking him bodily up off the mat, muscling him over his shoulders, and putting him into that torture rack.
Fans, we're back with a Minnesota Wrecking Crew 2, but first, a visit to Sullivan Slaughterhouse. Don't go away.
I love surprises. You know, surprises gives me thrills. Sometimes at night, I can't wait for the next day, so I will surprise myself, because Norman, every day I want to give you another surprise. Every day, Norman, I want to make your life miserable. Now you have a surprise in a box for me, Norman. You think I'm a child? You say in the box, there's the boogeyman. Well, Norman, I'm not afraid of no boogeyman, because nothing is as evil as I am, Norman. Not you, not the box, not the boogeyman. Norman, what's going to happen is I'm going to take that box and I'm going to look into it and I'm going to show you who the real boogeyman is.
He's one DA who likes to take on the big guys. Finding evidence when others can't. Now, Andy Griffith is on his toughest case of all.
You just don't want to believe he had anything to do with killing your brother. That'd spoil your chances at the big money, wouldn't it?
In Street Killing. Sunday at 8 on Lights on Hollywood.
You're about to see an amazing transformation as this bald man becomes unbald. Did his hair grow back? No, but the next best thing. New gradual hair replacement from Natural Look Hair Centers of Sacramento, Modesto, and Walnut Creek. This new process replaces hair slowly, over time, so no one will ever know. Hair that looks like it's growing back. From Natural Look Hair Center. Call for a free brochure today. Natural Look Hair Centers of Sacramento, Modesto, and Walnut Creek.
Got green with old St. Combs, coos, mud, holes and lumps, all the ruts and rocks that you're up against. You need Bridgestone Counties.
With just a finger's width of tire between you and the road, you need world-class technology, quality engineered to give you Bridgestone confidence.
Northern Tire and Wheel, your Bridgestone headquarters with four convenient locations to serve you. The confidence of Bridgestone and the quality and service of Northern Tire.
From Little Rock, Arkansas, this is Chris Powers. And his tag team partner is from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, Paul Drake. Their opponents are led to the ring by Ole Anderson. This is the Minnesota Wrecking Crew number two.
Now, Terry, I figured if anybody knew who these guys were and their background, it might be you.
Tell you one thing, they are so much like the Andersons in the ring that I feel that there is possibly some relation. There has to be, because watch how they go for the arm. Watch what they do. Watch their style. It reminds me of Arn and Ole themselves. And I'll tell you what, sure, they're tutored by Ole from ringside. That makes a difference. But there's more than that there. Look at the body structure. Tied up with Paul Drake, driving him into the mat, into the ropes. Headbutt, shoots him off. Power slam.
This Paul Drake has won numerous bodybuilding contests, among them Mr. Florida, now making his home in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. No slouch, this Drake, but he's being manhandled now by the smaller, the shorter, I should say, of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew 2.
Yeah, smaller at about 270. Yeah. Here comes the taller one now, you know. Both of them are massive guys. You know, that's one of the reasons that I decided, boy, I better get out of this sport because these guys are getting bigger all the time. And younger. Kind of scares me, Crispy.
Come on, Coach, get up!
I think that this member of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew has taken verbal abuse lessons from the Andersons as well. They were known to dish it out physically and verbally. And the Minnesota Wrecking Crew, too, following smack in the footsteps of the Andersons.
You see Ole Anderson, he's on the outside of the ring, and I know Ole like a book. He wants these guys to dominate this other team at the start of the match. You watch the Andersons, they constantly do that. They want to dominate, take control of the match, and then they'll pick out that body part and take it totally.
From beginning to end, now we see Chris Powers. Double axe handle blow.
Whoa!
And a body slam there. Now he's slammed into the turnbuckle. The Minnesota Wrecking Crew, both of them.
Typo of portable the fireman's carry right over there. Working on that arm. Now you see what they centered on, and you didn't even notice when they started it, did you?
I did.
But they got there, didn't they? They got to that arm. just like a dog chewing on a bone, you know. Once they get there, boy, they just don't want to quit.
And he slams Powers down on that left arm. Terry, it's been so long. There's a shot of Ole Anderson there. It has been so long since we have seen the arm bar used as a submission move. I think the last time was with the original Minnesota Wrecking Crew. And that's important to know. That the Andersons, famous for picking out one body part, in general it is the left arm, and going to work on it mercilessly.
It's been their signature for years. There you see him hanging onto those arms right there.
You can see the tendons here of the Chris Powers stretching painfully. And again, mercilessly going to work on the left arm.
And left arm and left shoulder. They come back to it again and again and again. Now you see him picking it back up for another slam. Both the Wrecking Crew have been going back for that arm again and again, kicking on that arm.
Fans, later in the program, we're going to hear some pre-recorded comments from Ole Anderson and then from the Steiners. As I said, I'll be talking live with Ric Flair in the ring. Our main event, Flying Brian against Bobby. Chris Powers might say, enough.
I'll tell you what, I don't know what you call it, but we might see that same maneuver again in the Kiel Auditorium just hours away. That's tonight.
Big event in St. Louis.
Oh, driving that knee right into that arm.
They worked on the left arm of Scotty Steiner, did the Minnesota Wrecking Crew.
I understand that they want that Steiner in a stretcher match. I understand that they want to get into that kind of a match. Just
the
straight arm bar.
The Minnesota Wrecking Crew number two.
I'll tell you what, now let's listen to these pre-recorded comments from Ole Anderson and then the Steiners. Then we'll go to the ring with a live interview with Chris Cruz and Ric Flair along with Woman.
You know, Steiners, it amazes me that being educated like you are, that you still don't have enough sense to realize that I'm never going to quit. It starts out with Scott being hurt. It ends up with Arn being hurt. Well, wait a minute. It doesn't exactly end up with Arn being hurt, because in between there was a time when we dropped both of you on your head on that stage. And I thought, surely, surely that degree that you've got from Michigan is going to make the light bulb in your head go off and realize that you're making a mistake going against anybody from Minnesota, let alone the Horsemen, let alone the Minnesota Wrecking Crew. Well, if you thought I was just going to turn tail and run, you're badly mistaken. I don't ever leave until the battle is finally over, one way or the other. I've got these two kids. You've seen them. Everybody's seen them. The Minnesota Wrecking Crew, too. And they're the boys that are going to get the job done, Steiners, and when they do, we're going to be wearing those tag team belts.
Throughout the years in this great sport of professional wrestling, there's only been three sets of brothers that were world tag team champions. First you had the Funks, then you had the Briscoes, and now you have us. When they were champions, all their tag teams were judged by them. Wrecking Crew, that's where you come in. You guys are guilty by association, and it's only a matter of time when you end up with Arn in the hospital.
The two Jugheads and Holy Poly, you guys have no chance at all.
Ladies and gentlemen, the world's heavyweight champion, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Said, give him a message for me, and that is, I have Ric Flair's number.
Well, Chris Cruz, If Luger's in this building tonight, and these idiots around us think he's something special like the little man you are, then Luger, if you're such a bad apple, why don't you appear for... Come and get it. Come on, brother. Come on, tough guy. Come on. Come on, tough guy. Come on, tough guy.
Doggy town, doggy, a half dozen dogs hot dogging, doing the dog double time. So what's Dogface Rick Steiner wear on his dogs? Ruse! Shoes for your feet, pockets for your stuff.
Hey guys, shouldn't be giving me a hard time. I mean, I may not be so big now,
but I'm drinking milk, cause in these years I'm growing faster than I ever will again. And I need milk's calcium for bones
and protein for muscle, more now than I ever did as a kid. In fact,
this is how I'm gonna look when I'm 19. I don't forget a name or a face. I'll probably have forgiven you guys by then.
But you never can tell.
Milk, it does a body good.
Starburst California fruit chews, four mouth-watering flavors like strawberry watermelon and Malibu punch. That'll give your mouth a splash of California.
Hi, I'm Jackie from the MTA Truck Driving School. Why are so many men and women leaving their present jobs to become truck drivers? The answers are simple. Better jobs, better money, better chances for advancement, and the ability to be their own boss. This booklet of information from MTA tells you all about it. I'll be back in a minute to tell you how to get it.
All over America, men and women from every walk of life are leaving their present jobs and getting involved in one of the fastest growing, best paying, and most exciting jobs in America, truck driving.
When I first told my wife I was thinking about leaving my job, she was a little nervous. But with a new baby, I needed a better income. Then I heard about MTA. They showed me that I could be my own boss, make good money, and still have time for my family.
At MTA, we have day, evening, and weekend classes that are designed to fit your needs, and this means you can keep your present job while you get your hands-on training. And with your new skills, you'll have many jobs to choose from.
Before I called MTA, I was a manager of a grocery store. The money wasn't that bad, but the job was boring, and I wasn't going anywhere. Then I called MTA. Now that I'm a truck driver, I've been to places that I never even dreamed of seeing. But the best part is the money. Because of the training I got at MTA, I finally have the kind of life I've always dreamed of.
If you're not happy with your present job, or you're not making the kind of money you want and deserve, then call MTA now. A better job, a better income, and a better life start at MTA.
In just the last few minutes, hundreds of people just like you, people who wanted better jobs, more excitement, and better incomes have called MTA. If you'd like more information about job opportunities or financial aid for those who qualify, then call me right now at 1-800-828-0804. There's no obligation, so call me now, 1-800-828-0804. In the past few years, over 35,000 men and women have started on great careers at MTA. Maybe you could be next. 1-800-828-0804. Call now and ask for me, Jackie.
Fans want to take you back to World Championship Wrestling and show you how Jim Cornette and the Midnight Express tried to break Brian Pillman's neck.
You know, I want to share something with you idiots. It's the funniest laugh I've had in a week or two. They're saying that Flying Brian has gone out and asked for a match against beautiful Bobby Eaton. Now, I know what you're saying. How could he be that stupid when just a couple of weeks ago he had the worst beating he's ever suffered in his whole stinking life against the Midnight Express? Well, that's what they're saying, but the match has been signed. Z-Man, you say, where is he? Why ain't it a tag team match because Z-Man, a thought entered his head, and before it died of loneliness, he realized that he didn't want to be anywhere around, because he's a yellow stinking coward with a yellow streak down his back as long as the interstate and just as wide. So let me tell you something, Flying Brian. When you get in that ring with beautiful Bobby Eaton, he has been wrestling since you were this tall, and that's how tall you're going to be when he gets finished with you. You talk about flying off the top rope. He spent more time in the air than a Delta pilot, and he's going to teach you a thing or two before he slaps you around, shakes you for change, and beats you. And just to make sure the referee don't cheat us, I'm going to be at ringside, and so is Sweet Stan, because the Midnight Express are sick of being ripped off.
Wrestling fans, the following contest is set for one fall. It is your TV main event. It is a special challenge captain's match. Introducing team number one.
Hey, what's Stan Lane doing out there? This is Bobby Eaton against Flying Brian.
It's our main event today. Chris be the captain's match. I guess he has a right to come out there and hold the ropes over for him, doesn't he?
Gentlemen and rednecks of all ages, I present the premier flyer in the world of professional wrestling today, one half of the Midnight Express, beautiful Bobby Eaton.
Well, Jim Cornette just said something that I think we can all agree on. He is the premier flyer.
What does he have?
The NWA Wrestling Wrap-Up, direct from World Championship Wrestling. Also, Terry, did you know there's a story on the background of Cactus Jack Manson?
No, I didn't, Crispy, but I know one thing for sure, that if Flying Brian kicks Jim Cornette in the heart, he might break his foot, and he doesn't have one.
A personality profile on Norman.
And a personality profile on Norman. Let's look what's going on in the ring right here. Stop breathing. Watch what we're doing. You're a commentator. There's action going on right now.
Stan Lane tries to kick dirt onto the umpire's pants. This isn't baseball. I know. I'm trying to make a point here, I guess.
Well, go ahead and make it.
I can't now. Forget it. I quit. Forget it. All right.
He's sending it back to the dressing room. He's sending Stan Lane.
Otherwise, it's three against two. And Cornette's got that loaded tennis racket.
Well, it's 2-2 right now.
Yeah, this is better.
Hey, stop reading the wrestling review.
Well, it's the wrestling wrap-up. And I was reading the personality profile on Norman.
I stand.
Give me
wrestling.
That back. Hey.
That's enough of that now. I'll buy you another one later. They're cheap.
Who's his favorite actor? See, you don't even know this stuff. Look, you need to read that wrap-up. Clean break there. Come on. Bob Eaton did not have his tights pulled by Flying Brian Pillman. A lot of bad blood here. A lot of bad blood. We have seen the Midnight Express do everything they can to win the U.S. Tag Team Championships. When they didn't do that, they stole the belts from Blind Brian Pillman and the Z-Man. They have tried to break Pillman's neck. A shoulder block, again with authority, and Stan Lane goes down. He's in the wrong place, and the Z-Man backs off.
I'll tell you what, tomorrow night in Baltimore, you're going to be able to see NWA Wrestling. Then Monday night in Johnstown, PA, we're going to be there, too, with WWW, right?
You and I, together again. In Johnstown.
And then Tuesday in Canton, Ohio. Then Wednesday we're going to be in Myrtle Beach in Harrisburg. Thursday we're going to be in Hampton at the Coliseum. How lucky. Oh, nice move. Beautiful arm drag.
Jesus Christ. Come on, referee.
He's not at all happy with what's going on in the ring. And of course, a reminder, we are just hours away from the Keel in St. Louis. The superb card. We hope to see you, fans, there.
I'll tell you what, I want to see my old buddy Sam Mushnick up there.
I'll be there for the 900 line with Lance Russell at the beautiful Kiel Auditorium in St. Louis.
Oh.
Tillman knocked out.
Terrific elbow there by Bobby Eaton. Tillman's on the floor right at this particular time. There's Bobby with him. What's he going to do? He's in a vertical suplex. Him on the floor. Beautiful maneuver. Oh, my gosh. Drove him right into that post.
That might say rules on the post. But when you're smacked into it, you say, ouch, and a lot more. A chop there from Pillman. Again, smacked into the ruse-covered post. A clothesline off the apron. And Eaton is out. And there's Cornette with another of his famous conniption fits.
What is a conniption?
I have no idea. It's just something we say in Maine.
It's got to be something horribly obnoxious if Cornette has one.
You come up with all your Texas sayings, and I just figure it's something to say in Texas. In Maine, we say conniption fit.
There's that rancid-looking individual again. Tries to steal my grill. I'll teach him one of these days.
Standing side headlock now by Eaton. Devin looking for a way to work out of it. That's a quick two count. Eaton got Pillman over with the help of a pull of the hair. So good to see the referee using his authority to make sure Stan Lane not able to interfere in this match and made sure that he went back to the locker room. This is our main event, this week's edition of Worldwide Wrestling. I can't wait to tell the fans what our main event is next week. Two of the biggest men this sport has ever seen.
I'll tell you what, we're going to have Teddy Long out here to tell us about it, too, in a little bit. About the Road Warrior Hawk going up against Butch Reed of Doom.
You just ruined the
next
surprise.
Next week. Drop down, leapfrog, another leapfrog. Catches even a power slam. Back up, a drop kick, a high drop kick.
Right in the mush, and again, Eaton is out. All right, some advice there. Covered by the tennis racket. Eaton is a high flyer. He's a superb wrestler. But the young Brian Pillman, give him his due. All right. Looks like Eaton is now back in the ring.
You want to make that mountain?
Do I what?
You said give him his due. I said, you want to make that mountain? You know, mountain.
I hope they're a sponsor. I really do. We're being sponsored this week by Castrol Motor Oil. Do you use that?
I drink it once in a while.
No, that's castor oil.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Good night. Turnbuckle. He's up on the second rope. He jumps over Eaton. He's again on the second rope. Blind body press, but Eaton rolls him right off. Blind head scissors. And a standing drop kick. He goes for the pin. Two. No hook of the leg.
What tremendous athletic ability this Brian Pillman has.
You'd expect Terry to see him drenched in sweat. You can't see any. Look, what superb cardiovascular conditioning on this young man as well. Following in the footsteps of Ric Flair for a time, anyway. Eaton pushes Pillman back against the ropes. Will we get a knee lift or will we get a clean break? Oh, we'll get an uppercut.
Get a hard drive.
A reversal there.
Neckbreaker by Bobby Eaton. You see what happened there? He knew that he came down. Missed that drop kick. Came down on the back of his hand. Then he picked him back up with that neckbreaker. Now he drops a knee to that neck.
We saw at the beginning, right before this match, we saw why Brian Pillman really needs to protect his neck after what the Midnight Express and Jim Cornette did, Terry Funk.
Yeah, they're going to it right now. If a dog has a weak point, you get out there. He's got his nerve, doesn't he?
Yeah, that too. Now Eaton is outside along with Coleman. Oh, don't drop, no. Is having severe trouble breathing. He's gasping for breath. He's spitting up. Oh no. I can't believe he's gonna try to get back in. Now Eaton's gonna help him in. No.
Back to that neck again, Marvis. They're going back to that neck again and again, Chris. Trying to win this match. This guy's trying to put him out of wrestling. Cornette's trying to put him out of wrestling. This has nothing to do with trying to
get a pinfall
to get a win. They are trying to put this boy out of professional wrestling. And they might do it.
This match may have to be stopped. This is too much.
It's a captain's match right here. Trying to come back at him. I'll tell you what, Brian Pillman is trying his best to make a comeback at this time.
Another neck breaker. Now Eaton should go for the pin. He does, but he doesn't hook the leg. Let's see if Pillman does cut. He kicks out. About 2.5 there. Eaton with a kick. He whips himself into the ropes, but Pillman follows up with a neck breaker of his own. And now both men flat on the mat.
They're both down. They're both down, both coming back up to their feet. Oh, my gosh. Oh. Two desperation chops right there. Shoots him off. Catches him in a backdrop.
Eaton is high flying. He didn't want to fly that high for that reason, however. Pillman tries to follow up, but Eaton was waiting for him. He whips him outside again, but Pillman up quickly. He knocks our cameraman down. He doesn't care. A flying Preston misses.
Telegraph that move, and Eaton moved out of the way.
This should be it. He hooks the
leg. No.
Pillman kicks out. Eaton has got to be thinking at this point, Terry, what more do I have to do to defeat him? Cornette is up on the apron. He tells Eaton to go all the way up to the third rope.
Is this a Vegematic? Yes.
Oh, he misses. The Z-Man pulls Pillman out of the way. A backslide. This could be it. One, two, and three.
He got the three count in.
Da alofa no pa ia ma malu o ka haka sa mo ki kilo ma TV ne yaso. Vetus ma upula titi vi vata alofa tu ya auto uma lava. Awa, sa mo ngu mela mo mo. Wa ma nge ava goe, pi e ma uma siuso, it fusi. Sfer kuma kala standards, uma uroa.
You know what that means, people? That means we don't like nobody, we don't trust nobody, and we don't need nobody to go to the top. Not even you, Kahuna.
This weekend, we were supposed to take up a new sport.
Mountain climbing.
Yeah, boy, I was really looking forward to hanging off an 8,000-foot cliff by my fingernails. Then I found out I could get a free game of bowling and a chance to win up to $100,000 in the A&W Road to Riches sweepstakes. So this weekend, it's A&W root beer and cream soda, our favorites, and some real fun bowling.
Next weekend, skydiving!
Look for the A&W free bowling display.
They said it wasn't humanly possible, but now you can have all the power and excitement of Nintendo right in the palm of your hand. Introducing Game Boy. It's portable, it's in stereo, and its games are interchangeable. Plus, Game Boy comes with the outrageous new game, Tetris. And for head-to-head competition, use the revolutionary video link and blow your opponent away. Game Boy, only from Nintendo. Now you're playing with power, portable power.
This is depressing.
How do you think they feel? You know, they could lose everything.
Hi, guys. Hi, I'm glad you could come.
I heard the insurance company was
stringing me along. Well, not since they had a talk with my attorney.
Why? What happened?
Well, I did something right for once. I called them. I got some good advice.
If you've been injured, get the compensation you have coming. Call Accident Counseling at 1-800-648-1331.
I made the connection. That was me.
Gary!
About six
Gary!
Months ago. Go away!
Gary,
I made some great dates, but I guess I overdid it.
Gary!
When I called
Gary!
Connections,
Gary!
There were
Gary!
So many interesting
Gary!
Messages that I thought,
Gary!
Well, I just
Gary!
Had to leave them
Gary!
All a message.
Connections USA. Connect with someone near you.
That ought to hold them.
Hi, Gary!
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Crisp Clean Dentine. We'll take care of your breath. The rest is up to you. Crisp Clean Dentine Chewing Gum.
Double Dragon 2, The Revenge for your Nintendo Entertainment System. The blockbuster arcade hit. Two-player head-to-head action. Double Dragon 2, The Revenge.
It's Electronic Battleship, where you program an all-out attack to sink your enemy's fleet.
You sank my battleship.
Battleship and Electronic Battleship from Milton Bradley.
This week's edition of Worldwide Wrestling has been brought to you by Castrol Motor Oil, engineered for today's smaller cars. Terry, I am hoarse. What an exciting hour of Worldwide Wrestling.
Oh, what a great show we had today, you know. And I'm going to tell you something. Isn't it going to be a great main event we got next week whenever we have Road Warrior Hawk going up against Butch Reed?
That's right.
I'll tell you what, that ought to be something. And I've got an opponent for you right now I want to call in here. I got a guy that I think might be able to take you in a hurry. In fact,
whoa, look
at those hands. Look how fast he is. That's Sugar Ray Long. Now, I'm going
to
ask you something. Oh, yeah, show it off. To
Teddy
him,
Long.
Sugar Ray.
Baby,
that's Sugar Ray Long. Sugar Ray Long. All right. You know, we can dance. You can hit. You can do everything you want to do, you know. And I'm going to ask you one thing right now. Who do you think is the best? The Road Warriors are you? Because we're going to find out here next week.
Well, let me tell you something right now, Terry Punk. I don't have to think who's the best. I know who the best is, and that's Soul Brother Butch Reed. And next week, these people are going to get a chance to see Soul Brother Butch Reed of Doom go up against that miserable, slimy Hawk of the Road Warriors. And I guarantee you right after Hawks get through with Ellerin, get through with when Butch Reed gets through with Hawk, let's get that thing right now.
Oh, yeah, let's get that right now.
That's right. Then I'm going to take care of Paul Ellerin, baby. I got Paul Ellerin. You've got 7 days to get out of town, brother.
You've got 7 days, Paul Ellery, to get out of town. That's 1 week. A hoochie-goochies, a wenus-noochies, and a so long, everybody.
And we'll see you next week. Bye-bye.